like to take a look at what are some of the problems of traditional accounting systems. We've only got a few minutes, so we can't get to a huge amount of detail here. But the first is reports that nobody understands. You know, I learned some time ago that when presenting lean accounting, it's always good to have a cross-functional group, because very often the finance people have a clear picture of what the reports are, but they don't realize that most people in the company, this information is a complete mystery. You know, things like gross margin. That would be the revenue minus the cost of goods sold at standard cost. You know, what does that mean? And then all of those variances that come up on the income statement, purchase price variance and labor rate variance and labor time variance and all of these. And my favorite is overhead absorption variance. No one understands that. And yet these things drive very bad behaviors. A second would be that just this idea of calculating a product cost, or as the cost of a product you're making, or a service that you're providing, or a process that you're completing, this idea of calculating a product cost is very misleading. And some of this goes back to things that we learned many years ago in terms of what are the things that drive cost. Most companies calculate a standard cost if they're in production. That standard cost would include material and labor and overhead. Now that means that there's a lot of distortion of what the true cost is, and this leads to very bad decision making. Actually, it's a step worse than that, really, because what we know now is that the cost of the product actually isn't related to the amount of labor that goes into it in most cases. The cost of the product is primarily driven by the rate of flow through the value stream. So not only is a standard cost misleading, it's also actually just calculated wrong. Now that's in a production environment, but what about in a healthcare or a financial services or something like that? Well, again, many companies calculate the cost of an individual service. What is the cost of providing a phone support to our customers? What is the cost of a doctor visit? These kinds of things. Whenever these things are done, they provide information that is misleading and harmful. And especially when people take that information and then take action against it, they do a make-buy decision. These are very harmful things. The third is complex and wasteful. When you look at the huge complicated systems that people have for tracking and gathering this information, you know, some companies have their employees clocking in and clocking out of each individual job that they do and keeping track of the work hours they spend on each project or program, or all of these things lead to thousands and thousands and thousands of transactions. We've been working with a very well-known aircraft company recently and over the last couple of years, and last year they eliminated 3 trillion transactions from their process, and that's up to 6 months ago, so there's probably a lot more that have been eliminated since then by significantly simplifying the complexity of these things. So that's briefly some of the problems, and I know a lot more needs to be said about that for people who are hearing this for the first time, but those are the issues that we're trying to address. Now, what do we do in lean accounting? Well, we don't collect our cost to a product or to a process or to a service that we provide. We always look at the value stream. See, the second principle of lean thinking is that we always work by value stream, so we collect our costs at the value stream level. And this is simple, summary, direct costing. You know, this thing about, what are the drivers that drive cost? You know, 20 years ago, when people addressed that problem and it became popular in business circles, then a lot of activity-based costing came into play. And, you know, we worked on that some years ago ourselves. But a long time ago, we realized that that lean and activity-based costing don't go together. What we're looking for is not fancy, clever, complicated ways to allocate costs. Quite the reverse. What we want is something that's simple, very little work, and easily understood. that gives us direct cost. What are the direct costs of this value stream, and how do those costs change based on what's happening within the operation? The value stream can be a production process, going from a sales through to receiving material, making a product, collecting the cash, or it can be a service process that might go from the first time someone calls and asks about a mortgage, through that whole process of validating the mortgage and then in assigning and providing the cash to the customer. Or something in a healthcare area, maybe in an emergency room, from the time the person comes in to the time they're discharged and sent home. The whole process, that's what we're looking to understand. Another thing is they're timely. We typically produce the financial information at least on a weekly basis. Part of this is because we want to control the cost, and the more frequently you report, the better you control. The old, you know, month-end report that comes out 10 days after the month-end and all that, none of that's useful. We want the value stream manager to be able to sit down with his or her people on Monday morning, looking at everything that's happened up to Sunday night, and being able to understand those costs and then work to reduce them. Like in Lean, we always have to bring it under control, and then we can start to reduce. This also motivates lean thinking. Just by the fact that it's measuring the value stream cost will motivate us to lean, rather than these departmental costs against budgets and all that kind of stuff. We want reports everybody understands. Must be, what, 4 or 5 years ago when Gene Cunningham and Ori Fumi published their book called Real Numbers. They coined that phrase, plain English income statement, or plain English financial reports. And that's what we're after. Financial reports that anybody in the company can look at and immediately understand. One sheet of paper, one side of one sheet of paper, with all the relevant information that's available for people to use. I always have problems with that when we go to countries where they don't speak English, but that's what we call them, plain English statements. And then again, we want something that's much less work. All of the complexity that people go through to produce financial reporting, we really want to cut most of that out and be able to produce valid reports that are simple and easy to do. We actually have one customer, and I don't recommend this, but we actually have one customer where the people in the factory do the financial reporting on a whiteboard in the factory day by day, and keep track of their costs as they go along. Okay, so that's value stream accounting briefly. Let's look at how do we make decisions then if we haven't got the cost of a product or the cost of the service?